मॉर्निंग बॉयस विल कंटिन्यू द एक्सरसाइज 1.3 क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. आई टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 यू हैव टू कंप्लीट एवरीथिंग एज होमवर्क. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज समथिंग इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस प्रॉब्लम्स. सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. आई गिव सम हिंट्स. सो यू हैव टू वर्क आउट द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. The price of three commodities A, B, and C are X, Y, and Z. The cost of the price commodities A is X. The cost of the commodities B as Y. The cost of commodities C as Z. It is given already in the question. So now see that purchase A, P purchase 4 units of C and sells 3 units of A and 5 units of B. Q purchase 3 units of B and sells 2 units of A and 1 unit of C. R purchase 1 unit of A and sells 4 units of B and 6 units of C. In this process, some transaction taken by the customer P, Q and R, it is all given. So in this process, after the purchasing and selling, finally P earns rupees 6,000. So how do you that store or shopkeeper earns in the business? If you say in earns during the business concept, that earns rupee, the earns word stands for profit. Profit is nothing but earn, the process. Buying and selling. So when the person buy the goods and sell the same goods in the market, he'll get some extra amount. That extra amount is called earn. That is nothing but profit. In the process, during the business process, purchasing some goods and selling the same goods to someone, he got some amount, extra amount. By doing this transaction, that extra amount is called profit or earn. So therefore, in this process, P earns 6,000, which means that is profit. What is the formula to find profit? Selling price minus cost price. This we learned already in the lower classes. Here the selling price, but cost price is nothing but purchasing price. Purchasing price is nothing but cost price. When you invest anything, some amount on one particular object, it is called cost price or purchasing price. When the same article sold to someone, that is called selling price. So the difference between the selling price and cost price is called profit, provided that such condition is selling price will be more than the purchase price. That is very important. But I don't know what is the cost price and selling price. That's what I'm using the formula P, because it is given very clearly earn. Earn means nothing but profit. So profit is selling price minus purchasing price. So P sold. P sold 3 units of A and 5 units of B. That is selling price. That's what I'm adding 3A plus 5B and purchasing price 4 units of C, so minus 4C, because selling goods minus purchasing goods, that is I am told for our understanding purpose, write selling price minus purchasing price. But you have to write instead of sell, actually you have to think this is sell number of units sold, this is purchasing units. Clear? For our understanding purpose, I wrote the formula like selling price minus cost price. Price is not given, but you have to take the sold things as selling price. So R, he sold 3 units of A and 5 units of B. It is selling price minus purchasing units. That is, how many units he purchased? 4 units. So minus 4C. Don't confuse. Sir, there is no price is given. Only it is given number of units. This just for your understanding, I write down the formula selling price minus purchasing price. Actually, outright selling units minus purchasing units. Number of selling units and number of purchase units. So this is number of units sold, that is sell. 3A plus 5B minus 4C. Similarly for Q, it is the Q sells 2 units of A and 1 units of C. So you have to add, then purchase 3 units of B, purchased by Q, so minus 3B. Earning rupees for P, Q process is given very clearly, 5000. Then similarly for R, 4 units of he sales 4 units of B and 6 units of C and he purchased 1 units of A. Total earning process of this is given 13000. So this is your equations. You know how to rewrite this equation in terms of matrix format. The cost of A is given as X. So you have to rewrite this as 3X plus 5Y minus 4Z is equal to 6000. Then 2X plus 1Z minus 3Y is equal to 5000. Then you have to write 4, what will come, X or Y? Y and 6Z minus X is equal to 13000. I did not rewrite. You have to rewrite that. I just write on the formula that hints. After that you have to replace A by X, B by Y, C by Z. So when you replace this one, you will get 3 equation in terms of X, Y and Z. Then what is the rule, basic rule? You have to write in standard form the equation starting from always X, Y and Z. So here it is given already X, Y, Z, but whereas second equation will get X, Z, Y and last one Y, Z, X. These two are not in standard form. You have to rewrite in standard form like X, Y, Z. Rewrite these two equations in standard form after replacing A, B and C by X, Y and Z respectively. So write general format, then you have to write in terms of AXB format, matrix format. When you take determinant of that matrix A, you will get minus 151. This is cofactor. Cofactor of the matrix A. This is your answer. Then adjoint A. So you have to work it out and check whether it is correct or wrong. Then after that, you know how to find out the value of X inverse, that is A inverse B. Apply that formula and find out what is the value of X, Y and Z. Clear? This is sum number 4. Be careful, this is equation. I gave only hints. What is given the statement in the question number 4? I am just rewriting in terms of the equations. You don't proceed as it is because the cost of A is given X, cost of B is given Y, cost of C is given as Z. So you have to rewrite the given equation as A is replaced by X, B is replaced by Y, C is replaced by Z. First equation is given, you will get in standard form, whereas second and third, you never get standard form of the linear equation. You have to write standard form of linear equation by starting with X, Y and Z. Then you have to write matrix format like AX is equal to B format. Then you find determinant of A, I gave, you have to check. Then cofactor of the matrix A is also, I wrote final answer, you have to check. Then adjoint A. So check all the steps and finally use this formula. This you know how to do it. Just you have to find out the value for X, Y and Z. Clear? Now we move to that next exercise, that is exercise number 1.4. This is very simple. Exercise number 1.4. So be careful, understand the concept, replace A, B and C by X, Y and Z respectively. Bring it into standard form of linear equation, then write in matrix format. After that you have to find determinant of A. I gave answers for all the steps, but you have to check. Don't simply copy from the board. You just verify after work out the problems, whether it is correct or wrong. Then you have to find out the cost of A, B and C by using this matrix multiplication with A inverse and B. So exercise number 1.4, here we are using the matrices technology matrix. to find technology matrix we have formulas. The formulas I will write down when I am come to that particular problems. Now see the exercise number 1.4, question number 1. I straight away go to the exercise because the instruction for the matrix is given already, so no need to give one more time instruction. That is introduction of the matrix. So I go straight away that exercise number 1.4. The technology matrix of economic system of two industries is given 0.50, 0. Technology matrix. That is TM, technology matrix. It is given 0.50, 0.30 and 0.41, 0.33. It is called technology matrix. And you are asked to find out whether the system is viable as per Hawking-Simon conditions. So you have to verify the conditions, that is Hawking-Simon's condition. That is Hawking-Simon conditions. You have to check. What is Hawking-Simon's condition is? Two conditions. There are two conditions. One is determinant of I minus B is positive. And second one, main diagonal elements are positive. So these two conditions, determinant of I minus B is the positive one, and main diagonal of the elements are also positive. So now that is I minus B. I minus B, main diagonals are positive. It is given technology matrix. You have to take the technology matrix as capital B. The symbol for technology matrix as capital letter B. You have to assign the technology matrix as B. Don't change A. Even if you take A, that doesn't matter. But normally, we consider the technology matrix as B. No, sir, I have to consider this one as A. That is your wish. You can take A also, capital letter A also. So B is equal to 0.50, 0.30, 0.41, 0.33. To verify whether this system is viable or not by using these two conditions, what is the condition number one? I minus B. I have to find out what is I minus B. I minus B. So you know already what is I. I stands for unit matrix. I don't know what is the order. I did not mention I2 or I3. It is given only I minus B. I told you already, if they mention only I, I is always stands for unit matrix. Depends upon the question, you have to take whether that unit matrix of order 2x2 or 3x3. Clear? If I say only I minus B, don't think that that unit matrix, we have unit matrix of 2x2, 3x3. The questions arise now, what type of unit matrix I have to take over here? That is the question. It is depends upon the question. What is the order of the given matrix in the question? 2x2. Therefore, you have to take only 2x2 matrices. Don't take the matrix of order 3x3. You cannot take this one because the question is given in 2x2. So you have to take that unit matrix of order 2x2. Don't take 3x3. Clear? So I stands for unit matrix. Whether you have to take the matrix of order 2x2 or 3x3 depends upon the question. Here the order of the given question is 2x2. Therefore, you have to take the unit matrix of order 2x2. So 1001 minus 0.50, 0.30, 0.41 and 0.33. So after the decimal, you are supposed to read the number only digit wise. Clear? Now you have to subtract. normal add subtraction, 1 minus 0.0, you will get 0.50. You subtract, then 0 minus, 0.3. Again 0 minus, normal subtraction, use calculator, 1 minus 0.33, so 1.0, 0.33, subtract 0, 9, 10, 7, 6. So, sum of the boys, they subtracted, this is wrong. So most of you are struggling that subtract the decimal number from the whole number. They committed so many mistakes. To avoid the mistake, please subtract by using the calculator, because you are allowed to use calculator. So you will get 0.67. Now you have to find out determinant. Determinant of I minus B. So this is 2 by 2. So how do you find determinant? Just apply the cross multiplications. 0.50 into 0.67 minus, I committed one mistake. Here I have to write minus. So formula minus, when you multiply these two, minus into minus, plus, plus into minus, minus. 0.30 into 0.41. So you multiply these two and see whether if it is positive, then the first condition is verified. Both conditions should be satisfied by the given technology matrix. Then only you have to write the system is viable. If only out of these two, only one condition is satisfied, then you have to write it is not viable, you cannot find solution. Both the condition number 1 and 2 should be satisfied by the technology matrix. Then only you have to write the system is viable, that's all. If anyone is not satisfied, either 1 or 2, your conclusion is the system is not viable. Are you clear? So both the conditions should be satisfied by the given technology matrix. The system is viable. Any one of these two conditions alone satisfied, then system is not viable. It may be 1 or 2. Both should be satisfied. You just use the calculator and find out. You will get positive. Then you have to see the main diagonal of I minus B. This is called main diagonal. So main diagonals are always, what should be positive. See, the main elements of the main diagonals are always positive. Therefore, both the conditions are verified. So you have to write whether I minus B is positive, second one, main diagonal of B is also positive, therefore Hawkins Simon condition verified. So which will give you system is viable. You have to check whether it is positive or not. If it is positive, diagonals are already, diagonal element of I minus B is positive, so the condition is satisfied or verified, system is viable. Instead of verified, you can write satisfied also. Nothing wrong. Clear? So based on this concept, you have to do the sum number 2 and 3. I will teach now sum number 4. Sum number 4 and 5, the remaining problems are same model. I will explain one more time. When the technology matrix is given, you have to consider the technology matrix as capital letter B or A, your wish. To check whether the system has viable or not, we have two conditions. Condition number 1 is determinant of I minus B is positive, then main diagonal elements are positive in I minus B. If these two conditions are satisfied, then you have to write Hawking-Simon rules verified or satisfied. Once these two conditions are satisfied, then you have to write system is viable. So the same model you have to apply to sum number 2 and 3. Now we will go to sum number 4. So this is 3 mark questions. You are allowed to use calculator, so simplify and write down the answer. If it is positive only, this system is viable. If it is negative, then you have to write Hawking-Simon conditions not satisfied. You have to write system is not viable. Now question number 4, it is given as a statement, very simple. Only the calculation part will take more time. Question number 4, I just explained, I will give the hints. I will work out one problem, then we will follow the same model for the remaining problems. Two commodities A and B are produced such that 0.4 tons of A and 0.7 tons of B are required to produce A. So there are two categories, A, B, A, B. To produce this A product, they need how many tons of A? 0.4. How many tons of B? 0.7. Be careful, to produce A, you have to take 0.4 tons from A, 0.7 tons from B. It is given statements, all right. Then to produce B, it is given. Similarly, 0.1 tons of A, from A you have to take 0.1, and 0.7 tons of B to produce B. To produce B, 0.1 tons from A and 0.7 from B. Read the question and see the tabular column. To produce A, I need 0.4 tons from A and 0.7 from B. To produce B, 0.1 from A and 0.7 from B. So this is called technology matrix. I call it as B, capital letter B, because B is always stands for technology matrix. Now, as usual, you have to find out I minus B. What is I? The technology matrix of order 2 by 2, so your unit matrix also 2 by 2, of order 2 by 2. 1, 0, 0, 1, minus 0.4, 0.1, 0.7, 0.7. Subtract 1 minus 0.4, 0.3. Is it correct? Because you know they will subtract 0.3. Is it correct? It is wrong. This is decimal part. You are subtracting the whole number from the decimal part. This is not actual subtraction. So most of you make mistake like this. 0.4 minus 1, 0.3. It's not like that. That is wrong. You have a calculator. You please use calculator. So 1 minus 0.4, 1.0, then 0.4. So you'll get 0.6. So don't make mistake like 0.3. This is wrong. 0.6, 0 minus minus 0.1, 0 minus 0.7. 1 minus 0.6. Is it correct? 0.6. Wrong. So don't commit mistake, it becomes 0.3. After that you have to find out. So determinant of I minus B. How do you find determinant? 0.3. 6 into 0.3. You know already how do you find determinant for 2 by 2. Same concept. Formula minus, this minus into minus plus, 0.1 into 0.7. So you multiply 6 threes are 18. 18 or 1.8, which one is correct? This is wrong. Because we have 2 digit. Keep the point after how many digit? 2 digit. So don't write 1.8. Use calculator, please. 0.18 minus 1 into 7.7. So 0.07. Don't write 0.7. This is wrong. 0.07. We have 2 decimal digit. So you have to count 2 digit and put the point. Subtract 0.18. 0.18, 0.07, we will get 1, so 0.11. Now we can check the two conditions. What is Hawking-Simons conditions? The main diagonal of I minus B positive. See, this is main diagonal or positive. Determinant of I minus B also positive. Therefore, the system is viable, not viable. It is viable. Conditions. Condition of Hawking-Simon rule satisfied. Therefore, system is viable. Now you can proceed. They are asked to find out what is the cross product production of both A and B when A needs 68 tens and B stands for 10.2 tens. So after verified that technology matrix B, we come to know that system is viable. After that you can simplify, that is formalize final demand, that is X is equal to I minus B inverse into the final demand. This is the formula to find required answer, I minus B inverse into D. To find A inverse, this inverse matrix, to find A inverse, what is the formula? 1 by determinant of A into adjoint A. So using this formula, in the place of A, what is given? I minus B, that's all, there is no difference. So I minus B inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of I minus B into adjoint of I minus B. I found already the determinant value of I minus B, that is 0.1. Now I have to find out what is adjoint of I minus B. So how do you find adjoint I minus B for 2 by 2 matrices? You have to interchange these two and change the sign of the remaining elements of the matrix of order 2 by 2. So now adjoint I minus B is equal to, interchange these two, 0.3, 0.6. Then change the sign of these two, 0.1 and 0.7. Clear? Those who are not follow how to find adjoint matrix of 2 by 2, just interchange these two elements, then change the sign alone for the remaining elements. Minus is become plus. If it is plus, plus will become minus. So I change. I got adjoint I minus B. Now I minus B inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of I minus B, we found already, that is 0.11 into adjoint I minus B. 0.3, 0.1, 0.7, 0.6. Now I have to find out the value x. 1 by 0.11 into 0.3, 0.1, 0.7, 0.6. The demand is given already. A stands for 68. And B stands for 10.2. Boys, After that, just you have to keep that previous model, previous exercise. First you have to multiply these two, multiply it, the next one you will get here, first row, first column, second row, second column, then divide each answer by 0.11, then you will get answer A and B. Clear? Use calculator. After that, you know how to simplify this, like previous exercise 1.3, you are finding what is x, y and z. So same concept, you have to find out. First row, you will get answer, you find what is A, B. Clear? So like the same model, you will get column wise. First column, then second row, second column. You will get first answer. Divide the first answer by 0.11. Divide the second answer by 0.1. You will get what is output for A and B. So after, up to this new, then after this process, you follow exercise number 1.3, normal 1.3. There you will get A inverse B, but here you will get I minus B inverse. That's the difference. Only difference between the previous exercise and this one, you have to find technology matrix B, then you have to check the conditions of Hawking-Simon rule, whether it is satisfied or not, then system is viable. After that, the same, like exercise number 1.3. So I will do the sum number 5. I will give only hints. I will bring up to this stage. After that, you can proceed at home. Clear? Sum number 5. When the technology matter is not given straight away, like question number 1 to 4, then you have to find out the technology matrix B by using some formulas. In the question number 5, the technology matrix is given, not given straight away, it is given matrix format. You convert into the technology matrix format, that is B. This is the formula to find technology matrix B. B11, B12, B21, B22. What is the meaning for B11? First row, first column. What is the meaning for B12? First row, second column. What is B21? Second row, first column. What is B22? Second row, second column. So to find the answer B11, technology matrix A11 by X1. To get B12, that is A12 by X2, what is there in the row, column, that should be there in the denominator. B21, A21, what is the column of the matrix A? That is 1, that is X1. B22, A22, what is the column of this element? 2, so X2. X1, X2 stands for output. You see the question number 5, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. First one stands for XY. Second one, the consumption, that is changes occurred for every week, is given. The domestic demand, that we don't bother about, you have to take only output. You consider the output as X1 and X2. So output is given in question number 5. X1 is 120 and X2 is 60. You don't take a domestic demand. You have to take only the output as X1 and X2. First one X1, next one as X2. Now A11, it is given matrix 30, 40, 20. It is given already in the question, 30, 40, 20, 10. This is given XY. Instead of AB, it is given XY, doesn't matter. So this is A11, first row, first column. This is A12, first row, second column. This is A21, second row, first column. This is A22. Just to apply in this B11. Find out what is B11. What is your A11? This is A11. First row, first column. By X1, 120. So simplified. Boys, in the up to sum number 4, it is given decimal. But if you use the calculator in the decimal values, final answer, you will get some different answer from that book answer. So to avoid, better you keep the elements of the technology matrices in fractional format. though it is exactly divisible by 1 is exactly divisible by 4, by taking you will get 0.25. sometimes if it is 1/3 it is non terminating, it is irrational number, it will be going on 0.3333. in such a cases you will not get exactly answer, so please keep that elements of the technology matrix as a fractional format even if it is terminating number. Then B12, what is that? A12, what is A12? 40. 40 by X2, what is your X2? 60. Simplify by using two table, 2/3. The next one, B21, that is A21, what is your A21? Second row, first column, 20. So 20/X1, that is 120, you will get 1/6. Then B22, A22/X2, what is your second row, second column? 10. 10/X2, that is 60. So answer is 1/6. Now you have to write technology matrix B is equal to B11, 1/4, B12, 2/3, then B21, 1/6, B22 also 1/6. So I got what is technology matrix B. Then you have to find out I-B. To check whether system is viable or not viable, you have to verify the Hawking-Simons conditions. To check whether the system is viable or not, we need to find what is I-B. Here I is unit matrix of order 2/2, because where technology matrix is, order of the technology matrix is 2/2. So 1/0/0/1 -1/4, 2/3, 1/6, 1/6. Just you have to subtract 1 - 1/4, 3/4, -2/3, -1/6, here 5/6. So no need to take 1 - 4. When you simplify 1 - 1/4, no need to go for LCM. Just you subtract 4 - 1, 3/4, that's all. If you subtract only number 1, if it is 2, then you go for cross multiplication. If it is 1 minus, straight away you can subtract the numerator from the denominator, keep it as a numerator, then denominator is always remain constant. So 4 - 1, 3/4. Or you take LCM, don't divide, don't rewrite this in terms of decimal number. If you write in decimal format, then you will get different answers. You may lose mark. So keep the technology matrix as it is, like fractional format, I-B. Next you have to find out determinant of I-B, cross multiplication, formula minus, here already plus, so plus into minus, minus 2/3 into 1/6. This will go 2 times, for 3 times, so 5/8 minus 1/9. Simplify, you will get determinant of I-B using cross multiplication, use calculator, then obviously you will get positive. 9 5s are 45, 45 minus 8 will give only positive. Therefore, first condition is verified. Then you have to see the diagonal elements of I-B is also positive. So you have to write straight away, that is Hawking-Simon rule condition verified, system is viable. After that, you have to find out adjoint I-B. What is adjoint I-B? Interchange these two. 5/6, 3/4, change the sign, 2/3, this will 1/6. Then as usual, X is equal to I-B inverse into D. So how do you find I-B inverse? Formula is given very clearly, 1/determinant of I-B into adjoint I-B. Then you have to find X. Find out this into D. So 1/determinant answer that you have to write into what is adjoint I-B? 5/6, 2/3, 1/6, 3/4 into the demand. The final demand is given in the question itself, 80 and 40. Final demand changes, 80 and 40. Just you multiply, like previous exercise, you will get answers. So, we will just you have to multiply, use calculator, otherwise next class I will complete this problem, you will come to know that your mistakes. Be careful of finding technology matrix, most of you are making mistake only I minus B, when they subtracting 1 minus 1 by 4, please do the calculations properly by taking cross multiplication or LCM, clear. And you have to check, I did not write the conditions, because the main diagonals of I minus B is positive, determinant of I minus B also going to be get positive, then you have to write condition Hawking-Simon rule verified or satisfied, the system is viable, the two statements are very important, after that you find out adjoint I minus B, then formula X is equal to I minus B inverse into D, you know how to find out the inverse of the matrix, 1 by determinant of the matrix into adjoint of the given matrix, just you have to substitute. Then D is replaced by the demand, it will be given already in the question. The final demand changes from 120 into 80 and 60 into 40. Just you write down the changes, multiply like previous exercise, you will get answer. Clear? You just multiply and keep it, and tomorrow I will beginning with this step and check your answer, whether it's got correct answer or wrong. Clear? Thank you, boys. We will see tomorrow.